Well, we're in a bit of a pickle, aren't we?
We did really, really well in the last game. But, unfortunately, we have a little bit of a problem going on here. And that's mainly poor old Gloria. She's surrounded by two extremely badass monsters. And there's just not a lot we can do.
Firstly, we have the same problem we had last time. The first player marker moves to Gloria and she has to go first, which means that she has to deal with this on her own. No one else can come to the rescue. Okay, so let's have a look at what she's got here. Her sneak is already at the highest. Plus, her fight is fairly low. She doesn't have much fight to her. She does have a rifle, which gives her a +5 combat check. So she's really got 6 fight physical. Okay? She's got a couple of spells, right? And one of them is a healing spell, which is very, very good. And importantly, she's got a cross, which gives her a plus to horror check. Still, she's not in a particularly good way. Now, unfortunately, both these creatures have physical resistance. So even though she has the +5, it actually becomes +2, because it's always rounded down in this game. So at the moment, she's got a total of 3 fight. So she has to sneak by these people. Okay, so let's have a look at what these creatures have got going for them. We have a +0 to sneak and a -1 to sneak. That means we get 3 dice to sneak past this guy, and at the moment we get 2 dice to sneak past this guy. That's pretty good, okay? What would really like 2 movement left over? Which, of course, we do. What am I thinking? Of course we've got 2 movement because she's got the map of Arkham. Ah, okay. Right. So I'm not going to change any of her things. Okay, now we have Michael Glenn. Now, just a little thing before. Michael Glenn's ability, I completely forgot about. Any phase, Michael reduces all stamina losses he suffers by 1 to a minimum of 0. That means nightmarish, this nightmarish thing he got. That means that goes back. And the 2 wounds he got from the warlock thing means he only got 1 wound, which means he gets another stamina back. So he's not nearly as bad shape as I thought. Now, he is in the other world, okay? And because he's in the other world, I really feel that we can start moving his speed down. So I'm going to move his speed down. Okay, good old Caroline, our top player. Now, what we're going to do here is actually move her lore up 1 and make it 5. And I think we're going to drop her fight down 1 because she can do 2 focus. Monterey Jack has a number of rolls we need to do. First, let's roll for the bank. 4, nothing happens. Now let's roll for the retainer. 2, nothing happens. So he gets another $2. Okay, so what we're going to do with him is we're going to increase his speed by 2 and give him 4 speed using his 2 focus. And that's all we're going to be doing for our pre-game thing. Okay, so can Gloria get out of this situation? This is the plan. We're going to move to the graveyard here, which is 1, 2, and she has 1 movement plus the movement from the map. But first, she's got to get past both of these guys. Let's do it. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is the polyp. Now, her sneak is at 3, which means she has 3 dice to sneak past this guy. If she doesn't sneak past, it's bad news. Okay, so that's a sneak. Nice. Okay, so that is completely passed. And now we have the doll. The doll is -1 dice, so now she only has 2 dice. Come on. And another pass. Whew. She's light on her feet.
Okay, so. Scared from the gibbering masses, she goes 1, 2 to the graveyard, using her map to get that extra piece of movement. And she's finally putting a bit of distance between her.
Next, we have our otherworldly travelers, and this is really simple. He just moves there for his turn. But for Caroline's turn, we're gonna activate the Cabal of Sabaoth. Exhaust and spend 2 movement points to make a law minus 2 check. If you pass, draw 1 skill. That's really awesome. And we can do this as many times as we want. Okay? Now, I'm not 100% sure of this, but I do believe that this movement is compulsory and does not take a movement point. Hopefully we won't need to find out, but if someone knows, you let me know, because I'm pretty sure it doesn't. Which means it's the perfect time to spend your movement points on these kind of cards when you're in the other world. Okay, so it's a law minus 2 check, and she has 5 law, which gives her 3 dice. That's why we pumped a law up so much for this one. Oh, 2 successes. That's awesome. So, she gets to draw another skill, which is huge. So, this gets discarded, and we draw a new skill. Okay. Law plus 1. When you spend a clue token to add to any law check, add 1 extra bonus die. That's awesome. Okay, so she's got a luck, and she's got a law check. That's very good. I have to reorganize the space. My cat keeps crawling on them and knocking everything down. And finally, we have good old Monterey. Now Monterey, we put his movement up to 4. And he's gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, and also go to the graveyard, which is very, very handy. Okay, so while he's at the graveyard in the location with Gloria, we're going to trade some items, and the first one we're going to trade is we're going to give her the silver key, okay? Give her an elder sign. Feel like I should give her the healing stone as well. I'm going to do that, and I'm going to give the healing stone. And then he's going to go back and start digging. She's also going to give him 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, she's not going to give him any money. Okay, so that's their trading done. Okay, so it's the first of the encounters at the graveyard. 2 encounters at the graveyard this time. This one's for Gloria. Testifying, Kuta Farewell latches onto you and rambles about his spiritual beliefs. Make a law minus 1 check. If you pass, then somewhere in Kuta's words you find a clue to the mythos threat. Gain 1 clue token, but lose 1 sanity. If you fail, move to the street while you listen to Cooper ramble on about pure nonsense.
She has 4 law, so hopefully we're going to get this. Okay, so 4 law means that she has 3 dice, I think. Yeah, it's a law minus 1. Come on. Oh, it's unbelievable. Oh well, she gets thrown into the street. Guess that polyp could follow her. She gets a clue token if she wins. Do we want to spend a clue token? I don't think so. So she gets booted to the street. Not good. Okay, so now the question is, Monterey has also got an encounter at the graveyard.
You find a man painting a picture of one of the horrible gargoyles lining the walls of the graveyard. Seeing you, introduce himself as Richard Upton Pickman, a painter visiting from Bosman. If you spend 5... we haven't got monster toughness. Yeah, we can't do this.
So that's a no-show. It's a weird rule, shuffling the decks between every pool. So you often get the same card again. Now onto the juicy mythos. So, we're looking for a blue and a red. Blue. Okay. The Abyss.
Okay. Monsters lurk everywhere. Pass a sneak minus 2 check or stay here next turn. His sneak is 2, which means he automatically fails. Now, we could spend a clue token, but then we wouldn't have enough to close the gate. So, we are going to have to be delayed. Okay. So, he's delayed, actually. Okay. Next, we need a yellow. Or a green. This is a green. City of the Great Race. You may choose to try and infiltrate one of the angled structures. If so, make a sneak minus 1 check. If you pass, draw 2 unique items and keep one of them. If you fail, you are lost in time and space. Oh my god. Yeah, so the thing is, in addition, if you're lost in time and space, you are devoured. Bad news, so we cannot lose this check. Okay, so she has 3 sneak. It's a sneak minus 1, which gives us 2 dice. Come on. Come on. Yes. That's how you do it, Caroline. You just go, dude, I am one sneaky bitch. Yeehaw. Excellent. So she can draw 2 items and discard 1. So we have the Pallid Mask, plus 2 to evade checks. That's very, very good. But we also have the Alien Statue, which is a fantastic card for late game. And what I mean by that is, you basically just spend 2 movement points and 1 sanity and then roll a dice. If it's a success, so that's a 2 in 6 chance, you can draw a spell or gain 3 clue tokens. And those 3 clue tokens are really, really good for later in the game. If you fail though, we get 2 sanity. But she's got that ally that gives a plus 2 movement, plus she's got the sanity regen. So every time this is a success, it's free. Meanwhile, the Pallid Mask is also great for her because she's got the plus 2 movement ally and she's got the Gem of Relia, which gives a plus 3 movement. So she can have 0 movement, still move 5 spaces, and this would give her 5 sneak, which means that she could get around the board extremely easily. So we could send her to all the other worlds, give her the Elder Signs. So this is a hard choice, but I think, I really think that the Alien Statue is the one we're going to go for. As much as the Pallid Mask is fantastic, and it really is, the Alien Statue is going to give us the ability to gain clue tokens, which is going to become a huge problem later on. And remember, we get 3 tokens, so we can roll, if we can spend a clue token, right, and we'll still come up ahead. You can spend, you know, yeah, so, I don't know. Oh, plus 5 sneak, just getting all around the board for free, that's also fantastic. You know, I'm going to change my mind. I'm going to go for the Pallid Mask. Probably not the best idea, but I'm doing it. I just can't get over the idea of her just having free movement all over the board. It's going to be huge, especially because we've got a digger that can pull those Elder Signs out so easily, and we've already got 2 of them. Okay, so that is the end of all that, and it's now the oh-so-brutal Mythos phase. Shwing! Oh, unbelievable! Seriously, this is unbelievable. Look at this. Black Cave has a thing, so we get a Monster Surge again. This is the 3rd turn in a row. Currently, we only have 1 spare token. We'll draw 1 monster. It's a Star Spawn. Pretty easy to sneak by, but again, very, very tough. Look at that. -3/-3, 3 damage. Okay, but we're now at the top of the monsters. So, we're at the monster limit. That means pull out 1 more monster, the cultist, and it goes into the outskirts. We now are at the limit. Okay? We pull a 2nd monster.
and a third monster. All the ones in the limit get thrown away, and these two monsters go here.
So we now have two monsters in the outer limit, so we can get two more monsters on the board. Meanwhile,
the Terror Track moves up one. Now this is pretty awesome. This represents how scary and just strange the Astana Arkham goes. And the way it's symbolized is that you randomly draw an ally and they are leaving town. And as you get to these colored numbers, things start to close down, like the general store will close down or the curiosity shop will close down, making there's less places for you to go to buy things because they're actually physically shut because the people have all run away.
Now remember, this is a visual deck, meaning that this deck is seen. You go through it by hand, so it's all... So you have to shuffle it before you do it. Okay. And it is... Ryan Dean. Oh, damn, it's a double. Draw a common item, plus we get a will and a sneak. Damn it, that's a really good ally. Gone. Okay, so here's the first chicken. Now we have the movement phase, and this is a huge movement phase. We've got octagons move on black. Octagon, which means the flying creature follows Gloria. And now we have star, triangle, and oblong. Okay, oh, this isn't good. Okay, we have one triangle. It's the Cathodian. Okay, now instead of moving, we roll, and on a 4 to 6, everyone loses a stamina. Okay, so finally we want to get a low number this time. And we get a 6. Great. So everyone loses a stamina. Okay, Michael doesn't lose one because of his ability. Caroline loses one. She's only got one left. And while I remember, let's give her back her sanity. Monterey loses one. And Gloria loses one. Now, how awesome's that? If I had not done that risk and killed off that last Cathodian, we would have actually had Caroline die that turn.
Okay, and finally we have quite a large rumor text. Okay, so let's read this. Rumor, ongoing effect. Roll a die at the end of every mythos phase while this card is in play, beginning the turn after it entered play. On a 1 or in 2, increase the terror level by 1. Oh my god. Pass. If a single player discards 2 gate trophies during the Arkham encounter phase while in Rivertown Streets, return this card to the box. Each player draws 1 spell. Fail. If the terror level reaches 10, return this card to the box. Every investigator is cursed. Activity at the Rivertown Streets.
Wow, that is one brutal, brutal, brutal card. Okay. Goes in there. Okay, so this is not good. So what we're going to have to do is hopefully Caroline is going to be able to seal the gate next turn. And she comes out of the Great City, which is a triangle, which will actually remove all dimensional symbol triangles, which is this guy, which is great. That'll get rid of a monster. And then quickly send her to meet up with Monterey, give her the Elder Sign, and get her to close the Black Cave. That's the plan, and then she's going to do the ritual in Rivertown Streets and get rid of that effect. So there's tons of stuff going on. Okay, so pretty brutal mythos phase as always, and that is the end of turn 6. And hopefully we're going to close some gates next turn. Catch you next time. Thank you.